The following is an endoscopic bileaflet mitral valve repair with preformed chordae loops performed by Dr. Antonios Pitsis of St. Luke's Hospital of Thessaloniki, Greece. Our patient is a 38-year-old man, breathless on exertion, who was referred with severe mitral regurgitation on transthoracic echocardiography. Transesophageal echocardiography revealed a bileaflet prolapse with significant mitral regurgitation, mainly due to flail A2-A3 segment and prolapsed posterior medial commissure and P3 segment of the posterior leaflet. Our incision is a 3 cm periareolar incision to enter the thoracic cavity through the 4th intercostal space. The 3D endoscope was inserted through a different incision in the same intercostal space in the right anterior axillary line. To enlarge the working incision, but also to protect the wound margins, the extra small Alexis wound protector is inserted in the 4th intercostal space. We use separate 4 mm incisions at the 3rd intercostal space right anterior axillary line for the Chitwood clamp, 7th intercostal space for the left atrial subsacer, again in the right anterior axillary line, and also at the 4th intercostal space right parasternally for the left atrial retractor. We cannulate the femoral vessels using Sendlinger technique. We use a 21 to 25 French femoral biomedicus cannula and also an 18 or 20 French EOPA arterial cannula, depending on patient size. For patients below 2.2 square meter surface area, we use the 18 French arterial cannula, and for the larger patients, the 20 French arterial cannula. Orthocannulae are inserted under TOE guidance. If we are to operate on the tricuspid valve, a separate right jugular vein cannula, 18 French, is inserted by the anesthetist. The whole of the operation is performed totally endoscopically using the stereoscopic vision that the 3D endoscope provides us. After going on full cardiopulmonary bypass, we open the pericardium from the SVC to IVC 3 cm above the right phrenic nerve by using diathermy. With gentle dissection, we position the subsacer in the oblique sinus. Following that, we dissect the first 3 cm of the SVC in order to facilitate exposure of the left atrium. Following that, we dissect the ascending aorta free from the right pulmonary artery using diathermy and also gentle dissection with the sacer. Until we reach the pericardium from the other side of the aorta, from the left side of the aorta. And then we are going to insert the Chitwood clamp with the jaws of the Chitwood clamp facing upwards. A pledgeted purse string is put in the anterior surface of the ascending aorta to be used for the cardioplegia line. The same line is going to be used for de-airing purposes after removing of the cross clamp at the end of the procedure. The aorta is cross-clamped and custodial cardioplegic solution is administered in the aortic root in order to arrest the heart. A left atriotomy incision is performed in the Sondergaard's groove anterior to the right pulmonary veins. After extending the left atrial incision, we insert the left atrial retractor through a separate 4mm right parasternal incision. Over the sump cycle, which was put in the left lower pulmonary veins. The mitral valve was examined and it became immediately apparent that there is a ruptured chordae in the area of the A2, A3 segments and also prolapsed posteromedial commissure and P3. A leaflet opening device was positioned inside the left ventricle in order to assist us to work in the subvalvar apparatus. The length of the chordae for the posterior leaflet was calculated as 18mm and therefore a preformed four-paired loop was anchored in the corresponding head of the posteromedial papillary muscle. The prolapsed part of the anterior leaflet was marked with methylene blue to facilitate the insertion of the synthetic cords. The required length for the anterior leaflet was calculated as 22mm. Then the synthetic cords were inserted in the posteromedial commissure and the P3 segment after marking the corresponding areas with methylene blue. A second pair of 22mm in length chordal loops were anchored in the posteromedial papillary muscle to be inserted in the corresponding part of the anterior leaflet. Before securing the last loop, we resected the ruptured chord of the anterior leaflet. Finally, we performed a posterior leaflet annuloplasty with a custom-made band made out of Dacron and titanium clips, and we secured the sutures over the titanium clips with the Cornot device. We performed a two-layer closure of the left atriotomy, the first layer being a horizontal mattress and the second one and over and over. After de-airing and removing the cross clamp and coming off bypass, transesophageal echocardiography revealed an excellent valve function without any mitral regurgitation and without systolic anterior motion of the anterior leaflet.